Kantian concept of autonomous self and enlightenment values of individualism has come to mold Western ways of experiencing the self set against the world and events. Here the self actually refers to the Freudian ego or ahankaram, the reality or mundane principle which is the coordinating experiential center of the individual personality. According to Losey, the term egocentric self refers to an understanding of the individual being as a self-contained autonomous entity. Psychological normality and abnormality are therefore seen as an integral process also limited to the self. The idea disregards the social origins of mental illness. Most of the world's populations, however, hold a more sociocentric conception of the self, where individuals exist within networks of social relationships. In this model, reciprocal and interpersonal privileges or obligations are more important than the rights of individuals. Significantly, the teaching of Buddhism is of anatta, that there is no real self, no essential underlying substance. While Hindu metaphysics points to a different perspective of the self as a reflection of a universal self. A better understanding of the supra-individual ethics can be sought through the ecological model of Bronfenbrenner with the micro, meso, exo and macro systems. Or to put it differently, the individual nested in the family, nested in the community, nested in wider society. The Bronfenbrenner model fits the WHO definition of health, which also emphasizes the need to look beyond the micro or individual level. Health is a state of complete physical, mental, familial, social, cultural, spiritual and ecological well-being, and not merely an absence of disease or infirmity. The family unit, I have put what I have added in parenthesis, has been included as its paramount in traditional societies, while the spiritual dimension is an essential part of cultures, most cultures. The ecological dimension rises from Bronfenbrenner's and environmental models and systems theory that emphasize an overall holistic approach, looking at how different levels, dimensions and systems with different temporal trajectories of their own influence each other to produce an interactive, dynamic, functional or dysfunctional whole. So this is a expansion of the definition of the World Health Organization slide, which I will go into later on, but mainly to show the different dimensions along this column and the manifestations at different levels. The disaster itself impacts on these different systems, but has a temporal trajectory of its own, which I will describe later. The WHO definition of well-being is artificially divided into physical, mental, social dimensions just to help elucidation, but they are in reality interdependent and interconnected. When one dimension is adversely affected, it causes disturbances at all other levels also. Health problems can be considered under these dimensions, under causes, symptoms and treatment. So one important intervention that has been discussed